Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I've got something super exciting for you. We now have Photoshop support for the touch bar on the MacBook Pro 2016. So we're gonna have a look right now. I'm gonna break this into two parts. Part one, I'm just gonna do just kind of like a workflow, just kind of demo sort of thing, and show you how it works. Then part two, we're gonna break it down. We're gonna go under the hood. We're gonna look at all the different options in there, as well as how to customize them and set it up how you wanna work. So the first thing we're gonna do is a little bit of dodging and burning on this photograph right here. So let's get started. So notice when I go into Photoshop, you can see the options there in the touch bar. So what we wanna do is we wanna create a new layer. So I'm gonna tap on the touch bar there, and you can see we've got three different categories. Then choose favorites and a new layer. And we can just click OK to apply a new layer. Now, I just want to change the blend mode in this to overlay. Now, I can do it this way here just by selecting it in the menu, or I can go back here under layer properties and we can choose the different blend modes right there, as you can see there. So we can scrub through them and we can choose different blend modes. All right, so next thing I want to do is hit B for brush. So now I've selected a brush. And what I want to do with this brush is set it up. So we're going to go there, choose the brush settings. And under the brush settings, we're going to set our size. So we can make it big or small, see that? We're gonna hit our opacity. And we're also gonna hit our flow. So notice here, you know, we can adjust the flow. The difference between opacity and flow, opacity is how transparent it is. The flow, the longer you keep pressing on that brush, the more intense it comes. Kind of like a paint or an airbrush would kind of work, all right? So great, now we want to set up the brush. So we want to choose some colors here. So notice we've got some colors. Now we can change these colors. We can simply tap here and we can change these individually. Hue, saturation, brightness. So in this case, I'm going to make it very dark, or I could go very light. Why don't we go very light and we'll do some dodging here. All right, so what I want to do now is I'm just going to begin to paint. Now don't forget, you know, all our other keys and everything like that still work. So if we want to lighten this up, we can just kind of paint. And right now I'm using a Wacom Intuos Pro Small. And what I'm doing is just adding a little bit of light here onto these front faces. See that? And, you know, I'm not going to spend all day doing it. I'm just going to do it very quickly just to give you an idea of the different types of things we can do and how this would apply to our real workflow. All right, awesome. So now I want to change the brush maybe to a black brush. So I can just tap here and I can change the darkness, the lightness, see that? And let's tap out and change the size. Now I might just paint a few shadows in with this. All right, so you get a general idea of how we could use this in our workflow here and how it can be really quite handy, particularly for things that would take a little bit more digging for a menu. So let's actually have a look and see what we've got in here. So if we hit the little button here, you'll see we have three categories: layer properties, brushes, and favorites. Now bear in mind, you know, this is the first release of this, so over time, you know, there could be more customization, more features added, you know, as Adobe usually does. But also let me tell you how to get the update. So to get the update, we're gonna go here and we choose updates. And then your Creative Cloud's gonna open. So here's a little tip for you though, because sometimes you see there's an update, then you go in here, you don't see your update in there, and you're like, well, why don't I have the update? Well, you can actually force it to update by going up here and then choose check for app updates. So there could be an update that you're just not aware of yet. All right, moving right on. So let's look at the categories here. So if we tap here, we see we got layer properties, brushes, and favorites. So if we tap on layer properties, you can see we have things like we can add a new image in here. You know, so if I want to drop something else on top, which I'm going to place the same image on top of itself, just for fun, we can do that. We can see, you know, we can change the opacity of the layer. So we've got our unaffected layer and, you know, over the top. So if we wanted to blend it, of course, you know, a smarter way to do it would actually be go here, grab our dodging and burning layer, and we could just dial in the settings we want for that. See that right there? And of course, we can hide or show that layer's visibility. So that can be kind of handy. So let's go back on this one here. And what else do we have here? Well, we have the blend modes, as we've shown, so we can tap on different blend modes and we can start to maybe grab this one here, and let's look at some of the blend modes and see how they work together. And you can see that we can just go through and try the different blend modes, and we can slide this backwards and forwards to scrub the different ones. So that's, you know, sort of handy. I'm going to be honest with you. The blend modes is probably not one I'm going to use a lot, because I can go up on the blend modes up here and change it quickly, or use this shift plus or minus key to cycle through the blend modes. But for newer users, this is quite useful. All right, so what else do we have? Here we have the option to go into mask, select mask workspace. So if you want to cut things out, you can do it there. And we can go there, and this is our history. This is kind of cool. So all these different things that we've done here, we can actually drag it out, and we can change our history state. See that? And we get that little preview on there of what those different history states look like. So that's kind of nice. And depending on the kind of work you're doing, you might find that these displays here are going to work really well for that. All right, so let's get out of there. And what else do we have? Well, let's have a look at the other categories. So we have brushes. Okay, so here we go. We've got our flow, opacity, hardness, and size, and those are just sliders. So what else do we have? We have colors. So if we choose on here, we have two different options. The first one here, this shows our color swatches, and I'll show you how to customize those in a second. Or we can tap again, and we go into hue, saturation, brightness. So hue, saturation, hue enables us to dial in a color, maybe a blue. Okay, so we go into our saturation here, and you can see the saturation shows how much of that color should be in there. Is it going to be a very bright blue, or is it going to be more faded? And then, of course, we go into brightness, and brightness is just how light or dark is it. So we can make it a very dark blue, and you can see the color there on the swatch, or we can make it a very light blue. So you can adjust that there using the HSB or hue, saturation, and brightness. You can dial in those individual colors. Nice. Okay, so let me just show you another thing. So if we go here in the swatches, you can see those are the colors there, but maybe if you don't like those colors, how do we change those swatches? Well, it's quite easy. We're just going to go up on our window, and what we're going to do is just open up our color swatches here. Now you can make your own custom color swatches, or you can just load them in just by clicking here. So maybe we're going to load in something different, like maybe web safe colors. And yeah, we're just going to replace it because I haven't changed anything. Now notice when I do, now the touch bar shows those new colors. That's quite bright, so it doesn't show well. Let me try a different one that shows better. So we can go under here, maybe grab some Pantone colors. And notice how now the touch bar is going to reflect those new colors. Now there's another thing we can do in here. If we click on one of these colors and hold it, notice that we get some variations of it. So we can play around a little bit and just choose a different variation of it. So that's how the color bar works. So let's get out of here. And let's look at the last setting, which is favorites. We can add, you know, a layer. And, you know, we can do different things there. So let's actually have a look at where the comprehensive list is. Now, the first thing you want to do is make sure you go into the favorites when you're customizing it. Then we're going to go into the view menu, and we're going to go down to customize touch bar. And here we are in the customized touch bar, and you can see these are the different things. Now, if we want to try some different things, like maybe we want to, I don't know, duplicate a layer, we click it, and this is kind of cool. We drag it into the bar, see that? And we can move that around wherever we want to do it. So, you know, maybe we want to step backwards, and maybe we want to, I don't know, let's go back up there, maybe we want to step forwards. And you can see how we can just put those things right there on the touch bar. Now, the other thing you can do is if you want to reset it, just grab this and drag it, and that'll go back to the factory settings. So we just click done when we're finished, and now we've customized those options there. All right, guys, so that's the touch bar with Photoshop. If you like this video, slam that like button right now. Give us a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate that. Also, if you're not a subscriber, hit the subscribe button right now, and you'll get Photoshop tutorials and different gadget reviews and stuff every single week from Photoshop Cafe. But let's talk about this for a second. What do you think about the touch bar? Do you think it's the most amazing thing to ever happen to computing, or is it a complete gimmick? Do you think this is something that will speed you up, or do you think it's something you might play around for a little while then just kind of lose interest in it? Would the touch bar make you want to buy a MacBook Pro, or is it the thing that's holding you away, obviously, apart from Donglegate? But anyway, let me know your thoughts. Drop them in the comments underneath. Let's get a discussion going. Don't forget, become a subscriber if you're not already. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.